Hello, darlings. You've all heard of Marilyn Monroe. Some of you know Bridget Bardot. Well, now it's time for the Cognac Show. I said Cognac, ooh, ooh. I said Cognac, ooh, ooh, ooh. I'm a bubbly blonde, fabulously dressed.
Welcome back, darlings. I'm Cognac with Elaine, and we are here at the International Emmy Awards. It's going to be a fabulous night filled with stars, movies, and celebrities, and international television. Keep watching. More interviews coming up. Pink champagne. Kisses. International Emmy Awards, and I'm here with these lovely people, and they're going to introduce themselves to the camera.
My name is Kate Horn, and I'm producer of the film Gabba, which is in competition for the Best Arts Documentary.
And
my name is Justin Rose, I'm the director of the film.
And tell my audience the synopsis of this film.
Well, it's a story about the power of the imagination and the story of Nobel Prize-winning author Gabriel Garcia Marquez, and they called him Gabo in his home country. And it's about a boy from nowhere in Colombia, backward village, became, you know, one of the greatest writers the world has known and the Spanish language. And that's Justin will tell you more as the director.
Yes, as the director, what inspired you to take on this film?
Well, I think all of us. I mean, Kate was the one who had the idea of making a film about him. There was no film, really, about Gabriel Garcia Marquez, who's one of the greatest artists of the 20th century. And so we'd all, I think our generation is all connected with his books. 100 Years of Solitude is a book I think lots of people have read. They've sold 50 million copies around the world.
It's a great book. Fascinating.
It's a great book. It's a book, I think, that changed our way of looking at things. And I think Gabo, Garcia Marquez, was a force of huge imagination and humanity.
Well, you guys look terrific, and in show business here in America, I don't know in your country, but here we say break a leg. And you look stunning. This gown
Thank
is
you.
Beautiful. Can you tell my audience what it's
like? Yes, it's by a designer called Silvia Cherassi, and she is the leading kind of designer in Latin America, and she's a famous Colombian designer. And she had the inspiration, she designed a whole collection based on the writer and his famous, most famous work.
You must be freezing.
I am cold, I can't lie.
Well, I won't keep you much, and like I said, break a leg. Thank you.
Thank you.
We'll be back in a moment, darlings. More interviews coming up. Keep watching. Pink champagne kisses. Okay. I'm Cognac with Elaine, and I'm here with James Wen from Echoes of Time. Now, tell my audience what you are exactly being nominated for.
I think this drama shooting in Singapore, very successful. Now I can nominate, I came here, so exciting for me. I'm Asian.
Yes, it's very exciting to be here at the International Emmy Awards. Yes. It's excellence in television all over the world.
Yes.
And an American actor is going to be presenting an award, possibly to you. Are you up for Best Actor, or what is it for the Is it for the role or is it for the actual movie?
You mean opportunity, a chance? You mean?
Is he nominated for Best Actor?
Yes.
Best Actor, or is the film nominated for Best Film?
No, James is nominated as the Best Actor.
Best Actor.
Yes. Well, darling, you're very handsome, and I'm sure you're an excellent actor. And I'm sure you're gonna win. I'm psychic about this.
I hope. You know, be an Asian.
Well,
I can.
You know, you've got Dustin Hoffman there, so I don't know.
Dustin Hoffman, not
Dustin,
here.
I know, but they might give it to him anyway. They do that.
I think be an Asian. I hope we can win again. But just once.
Just to be nominated is a thrill.
Uh-huh.
And as we say in show business, break a leg.
Mm-hmm. You mean
to win.
To win.
It's a superstitious remark, break a leg. Can I ask you, this movie you're receiving for Best Actor, can you tell us a little bit about the character, your character in the movie?
能不能让他知道这个角色的目的跟是什么一个？
This character is based in 1940. You know, it's a second world. Japanese aggression to Singapore. And so many people in dark times. So my a man. Go back, go to the future and see the beautiful future. They come back past.
Fascinating. Well, thank you for the information, and I hope you do win. And as we say in show business, break
a
leg.
Thank you.
And we'll be back in a moment, darlings. More interviews coming up. Keep watching. Pink Champagne Kisses. I'm Cognac with Elaine, and I'm here with Ed Schultz, and he's presenting tonight one of those fabulous awards at the International Emmy Awards. Tell my audience what are you presenting for?
Well, we're presenting tonight the winner of the documentary series. The documentary that there's four finalists tonight. It's a great night. It's a great honor for them when you consider how many documentaries are produced worldwide, the countless hours of preparation, research, and detail that go into documentaries. And so I'm expecting to have an exciting night. We have four great finalists. It's going to be fantastic.
Well, have a fabulous time.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Nice to see you.
We'll be back in a moment, darlings. More interviews coming up. Keep watching. Pink Champagne Kisses. Welcome back, darlings. I'm Cognac with Elaine. We're here at the International Emmys. And I'm here with one of the actors, one of the nominees.
Yeah.
Introduce yourself to the camera.
Well, my name's Florian Stetter. I'm in the film Naked Among Wolves.
Naked Among Wolves.
Yes. We are nominated.
Title.
Yes, it's Naked Among Wolves because it's a story about a young boy coming into the concentration camp in Buchenwald. It's quite a sad story, but it's a true story. A young boy was carried by a suitcase inside the camp, and he survived because of the prisoners. They took care of him, and I'm one of the prisoners taking care of the kid, and he survived. And he's over 90 right now, living in Vienna, and he survived it because the prisoners.
Is this a true story?
It's a true story.
My goodness. Yeah. Fascinating.
It is.
You're nominated as Best Actor.
Yes, and also the film. Also the film.
You know what it is? Your language, your English is so good.
Thank you very much.
I'm thinking you're an American actor, but I'm forgetting that you're not.
Germany.
That's what it is.
Yeah. Have you ever been to Berlin?
No, but my husband would
there.
Like, I'd like my husband to take me to Berlin.
Yes, you should go there.
Can we follow you? Do you have a website, a Facebook page,
Instagram? No, but over my agency, you can...
Well, tell my audience your name. Spell your name.
My name is Florian, FLORIANSTETTER. Stetter.
I can't follow you on Facebook?
No, I quit Facebook, to be honest.
All right.
You know, but...
I don't blame. It's kind of... It's a... It's... It's a little crazy.
Yeah, it is. So
well, but
I made a decision, you know. But let's wait and see.
But you're my fan right now. And as we say in show business here in America, break a leg.
Yeah, great. Good to meet you.
And we'll be back in a moment, darlings. More interviews coming up. Keep watching. Big champagne kisses. I'm Cognac Willa-Lane. We're here at the International Emmy Awards, and I'm here with some nominees. Introduce yourselves to the camera.
Hi.
Hi.
Her name is Natalia.
My name is Natalia.
My name is Alan. We're both from Brazil, and we're nominated for Hidden Truth.
Hidden Truth. Can you tell us about the synopsis?
It's a little mini-series about this girl who's a model and turns to become a prostitute. It's very dark.
Very dark. Well, I wish you luck. I hope you win. As you say in show business,
you
break a leg. What's your name again?
Natalia Greenberg.
And Alan Fitterman.
Fabulous.
Thank you.
We'll be back in a moment. More stars right here on the red carpet. Big champagne kisses. Darlings, I'm Cognac Willa-Lane. I'm here with this actress. She's absolutely stunningly gorgeous. She's going to introduce herself and tell us what she's being nominated for.
I don't know the name in English because...
Well, say it in Spanish. It's okay.
A regra do jogo.
Fabulous.
A regra do jogo. I don't know how can I say in English.
Can you tell us the synopsis? Is it a film or a TV show?
Soap opera.
Oh,
soap opera.
Brazilian, yeah. Fabulous.
Yeah.
Okay, so it's up for best, what is it, like telenova?
Yeah.
Ah, okay.
Yeah.
You look stunning. Tell my audience, what are you wearing? It's gorgeous.
Yeah, Elo Rocha, a Brazilian stylist.
That's gorgeous. Oh my God, all those nail heads. Oh my God, it's beautiful.
Thank
but you. But
you
must be freezing.
Yeah, I'm freezing.
You got a fur like this. I'm not cold at all. Could you spell your full name? Your full name?
Carolina Dieckmann. D-I-E-C-K-M-A-N-N. Oi.
Carolina, you're gorgeous. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. Bye-bye.
We'll be back in a moment, darlings. More interviews coming up. Big champagne kisses. Darlings, I'm Cognac Willa-Lane. We're here at the International Emmy Awards, and I'm here with the stunning. Are you an actress?
No, not at all. I'm a producer.
You're a producer,
yes.
And your film is being nominated. Your TV show film is being nominated.
Yes, my non-scripted show, Adotada.
Tell my audience, what is the name?
The name is Adotada in Portuguese. In English, it's The Adopted.
The Adopted. Can you tell us the synopsis?
Actually, it's a girl, Maria Eugênia. She's the host, and she's a very eccentric girl that is adopted in each week in a different family. Very special family, very, very interesting families. So she's very exotic, and so she interacts with different families every week.
Fascinating.
Thank you.
I love this gown that you're wearing. Who's the designer?
The name is...
I love this gown that you're wearing. Who's the designer?
The name is Isabella Narci.
Isabella Narci.
Yes.
And the fur?
The fur, it's not real.
It's not real?
No, it's not real.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I'm a vet, so I would not use a real one.
It looks very good. It looks very good.
It's a good quality.
Yes. Now tell my audience, if we want to learn more information about this, is there a website?
Yes, it's an MTV show. So if you try MTV Brazil, definitely you'll find The Adopted, Adotada there.
The Adopted.
Thank you so much.
We'll be back in a moment, darlings. More nominees, more celebrities right here on the red carpet. Big champagne kisses. International Emmy Awards. Introduce yourself to the camera.
Yeah, I'm Song Yang Lee, a producer. I Can See Your Voice. It's nominated for non-scripted entertainment from South Korea.
And who is this young lady?
She is my international project manager.
Oh, okay.
Both are gorgeous.
Thank you so
and
much.
As we say in show business, break a leg. But ladies, when you come to New York at the International Emmys, you got to wear a fur. There's just no way around it. It's just too cold.
Yeah, so cold actually. But this is really, really exciting.
It's very exciting.
Break a leg.
Thank you. We'll be back in a moment. More interviews coming up, darlings. Darlings, I'm Kanye Kololane. We're here at the International Emmy Awards, and I'm here with these gentlemen and this young lady, and it's about their Canadian project. They're from Canada.
That long, young lady? Oh, yeah. Thank you so
yes.
much.
Oh, you are, darling. You are. So tell my audience, first of all, introduce yourself to the camera.
I'm Fabienne Larouche, producer and writer of Trudy Lice, the showrunner.
And a producer, Michel Trudeau.
And my name is Emile Proclutier. I was the main actor in this season of Trudy Lice. Yes.
Now, this film is being nominated for, tell my audience what it's being nominated for.
Nominated Best Telenovela.
Oh, telenovela.
Yeah, okay. But it's from Quebec, so it's a bit awkward, because usually telenovela are from South America or Brazil.
Yes, usually.
But it's our third time, actually.
So could you tell my audience the synopsis of this this film?
Yeah, you want to say it again?
Okay. Well, it's Trudy Lice. I've been was showing for 5 years and a half, and it takes place in a high school, and each season there's a main character who's the teacher, and it changes every season. And well, I was a musical teacher, but it was gonna be geography teacher or math teacher, whatever. And he's in front of his class, 30 lives, so 30 kids, and each week we go into the he has to solve a problem of one of these kids, so he meets his parents, and it's a way to dive into some preoccupations and themes that for the young kids. So
you must have a lot of patience.
What?
You must have a lot of patience.
Yeah, and you have to be very you have to be in shape, because we shoot at a very fast pace, and well, we shoot we shoot in a week, and it's shown in the TV like 2 weeks later or 10 days later. So it's very fast.
Well, American soap operas are like that too.
Yeah.
They get very little time to remember your lines. Yeah. And I know, I'm an actress too, by the way. So I know what you're talking about. Okay, well, I wish you guys lots of luck. As we say in show business, break a leg. Beautiful.
Thank you.
Well, lots of luck, guys. Let me give you a kiss. Bye.
Okay. Other side, in French, two sides.
We'll be back in a moment, darlings. More interviews coming up. Pink champagne kisses. Darlings, I'm Cognac Willalane, and I'm here with Peter Scolari. He's a fabulous actor. We know him for so many incredible films and productions, Broadway productions, and he's here tonight to present an award. Tell my audience what you're presenting.
It is my distinct honor to be presenting Best Actress.
Best Actress?
Yes.
What do you think's going to win?
Well, smart money's on Judi Dench.
Me too!
But I'm sorry, I predict an upset. And I don't mean an upset to Miss Dench. She'll be fine. But I don't think she's going to win.
You really don't think she's going to win?
You know, the product out there is so diverse and so interesting. And if this isn't a season for dark horse candidates or people who are doing something so sensitive and so original, the kind of work that, you know, we haven't seen them doing. I've seen a little of this, not all of the nominees, but it's going to be someone outside of the United Kingdom.
Really?
Yes.
Okay, well, I was hoping that Dustin was going to him for Best Actor, but we shall see.
We shall see.
We shall see.
It's fun, right?
It's I loved it. I've been doing this for 10 years, coming to the International Emmy Awards. What about you, Peter? What are you up to?
I play the sometimes wonderful Wizard of Oz in Wicked on Broadway. I'll be there through Christmas and a little beyond. I've been doing that all year.
Well, you're going to have a fabulous time tonight. Have you ever been to the International Emmys?
I have not.
I've been doing it 10 years, darling. I've interviewed tons of celebrities, tons.
I have no doubt.
And I've had a lot of fun doing it. Really, I have a lot of fun doing it. Now, tell my audience where we can go find out about you. You have a website, Facebook page?
I'm blessed that I have a career. So, we have a sixth season of Girls that's coming up. We just finished filming. I finished a few weeks back. So that's pending. And then in February, I'm free to get back into television and film, and I'll probably be in California seeing what I can figure out there.
Karen coat, a Dolce & Gabbana dress, and Dolce & Gabbana shoes.
Now, Bernadette, I understand that you're presenting tonight.
Mm-hmm.
Tell us what you're presenting.
I'm presenting the Special Arts Award.
Special Art Award. Now, what's up with you, Bernadette? What are you up to?
What am I up to?
Yeah,
I'm in Mozart in the Jungle. That'll start streaming again December 9th. So watch it. You'll love it. It's on Amazon.
You look gorgeous, darling. We'll be back in a moment. More interviews coming up. Pink champagne kisses. I'm Cognac Lalaine. I'm here with Sarah Rafferty right here at the International Emmy Awards, and she is one of the presenters, looking very, very pretty in all these beautiful pastel colors.
Thank you.
Tell my audience, what are you presenting for?
I'm presenting TV miniseries.
TV miniseries. So yes. That's the category that you're presenting. Interesting.
Yeah.
Now, what have you been up to?
I just a day ago finished season six, say that 10 times fast, of Suits. Season six of Suits.
Yeah, that looks like a very sexy show.
It
kind of has
like
a retro feel about it.
Yeah.
Do people tell you that?
Yeah, I mean, I think there's a timelessness to it. Yeah, I think you've keyed into good element.
I used to work for a lot of Suits back in the day before I was a host for what I'm doing now. I used to work as a secretary, so I know what that's like.
Well, I play a secretary, so we have a lot in common.
A beautiful red-headed secretary. I can give you some tips about how secretaries used to act back in the day when the boss used to chase you around the desk.
That's not happening on Suits.
No, I don't think so. But you are a beautiful actress, and can you tell us anything else you might be doing besides presenting here tonight?
Besides presenting here tonight, I am going to be cooking Thanksgiving dinner in Toronto for my parents on
That's
Thursday.
Wonderful, yes. Wonderful. What are you wearing? This is a beautiful...
Thank you. I'm wearing a Christian Siriano gown and a Georgine coat.
Gorgeous,
thank
gorgeous.
You.
As we say in the show, this is Breakaway.
Thanks. Thank you.
Thank you.
We'll be back in a moment, darlings. More interviews right here on the red carpet. I'm Cognac Lalaine. We're here at the International Emmy Awards. I'm here with the stunning. You are stunning.
Thank
actress.
You so much.
Introduce yourself to the camera.
My name is Rita Pereira, and I'm from Portugal, and I'm an actress. This year I came as a judge.
Oh, you're judging?
This year, yes.
And hopefully we're going to find out who you're voting for.
Yeah, I already voted, so let's see if the ones I voted, they're going to win or not.
Can you tell my audience, do you have a favorite? Is there anything?
A favorite one?
Yeah.
Yes, I have a favorite one. There's a telenovela called... Verdades Secretas, and that's the one I wanted to win.
Well, I hope they do win. I hope they do. Fabulous. And the gown. Tell my audience, the gown is absolutely the most romantic gown. Stunning.
Thank you so much. It's from a Portuguese designer called Micaela Oliveira.
You must be freezing.
I am freezing, but I'm pretending I'm not.
Well, you're an actress, and you're a good actress, because most women would be shivering out here.
Yeah.
But thank you very much.
Thank you so much.
As we say in show business here in America, break a leg.
Yeah, thank you.
We'll be back in a moment, dollies. More interviews coming up. I'm Cognac Lalaine. We're here at the International Emmy Awards, and I'm here with actor Solomon Chertok. So, Solomon, this is a fabulous evening tonight. We're here at the International Emmys. Tell my audience, are you working on something new?
Oh, yeah. I'm working with Archetype Cinema. You can find them on Facebook, Archetype Cinema. facebook.com/archetypecinema, and they're doing a whole bunch of sci-fi movies. I was in their movie Parasitic, where I actually am the voice of the computer known as the Overseer, and that's actually, if you like movies like Alien, Predators, you would like this film. It's from John Anthony, and it was shot in Connecticut, and it's really, you know, it's spectacular. The special effects are amazing.
Yes, you were telling me you wear a spectacular mask. Pretty airy.
Well, that's actually the next movie I'm doing with him, is for the movie Coven, which is going to be which actually started shooting, but I'm playing the main villain in the movie, which...
How exciting. That's so wonderful.
And believe it or not, to show your audience, if here's the mask. I don't know if you guys can see it, but here you go.
Wow.
That, I'll be wearing that and also shaving my head for the role.
Oh my God.
I'm the big villain. I play Fearless Citizen in the movie, and the film Coven is kind of like Lord of the Rings or Thor or Willow, one of those sci-fi fantasy movies with a lot of action adventure. And basically, my character is trying to stop the main hero, who basically is sort of a demigod. And we live in this world of gods and goddesses. This goddess of screams, her daughter has married to Coven, and she wants that broken up. And Fearless Citizen over here, who happens to be sort of like a prophet, like a Ming the Merciless type of character and follower of her, tries to break up the marriage. And
when
by any means necessary.
When is this supposed to be released now?
The film is right now shooting, so I figure by the end of next year it'll be done and doing the film festival circuit. Parasitic, which is done and doing the film, starting the film festival circuit now, will be at a film festival sometime in 2017.
How exciting. You must be so thrilled.
Absolutely. Well, a lot of action scenes I get to do. Like for COVID, I'm three characters, Fearless Citizen, the Overseer, the computer, which looks amazing as the voice of that computer. And I play an agent as well, so it's a lot of physicality.
Now, if we want to find out more information about these films, where can we go? Do they have a Facebook page,
yes,
a website?
Facebook.com/archetypecinema. You can see the trailer for Parasitic, which looks also amazing, as well as videos of their past work. They've won awards at the Macabre Film Festival. The guy did a film with, John did a movie with Scream Queen Genevieve Rossi. And you can find all the information on the Facebook page.
Terrific. Well, Solomon, as we say in show business, break a leg.
Absolutely. Well, in this case, with their movies, they're breaking more than legs. Arms, heads, faces, they break everything. And he's creating his fractured universe, kind of like Marvel, where he's shooting these short films and putting them all together, kind of like the Avengers. So it's going to be exciting.
Fabulous.
They came here because you put out an ad asking for drug addicts to come in and make money as part of a rehabilitative research program. Some came for flu vaccines, others just desperate for money to survive. You chose the ones with the least attachments so nobody would ask any questions.
Containment Protocol Number 1. Avoid all contact with the infected.
I've had too many.
More interviews, more celebrities, right here at the International Emmy Awards. Pink champagne kisses. Fabulously dressed to impress. One of a kind
girl. This has been a Crybaby Productions, darlings.